Today we'll talk about LCA Tejas, India's second supersonic combat aircraft after the HAL HF-24. In this discussion, we'll cover the squadron strength of the Indian Air Force, the advanced sensors equipped on the Tejas, any potential gaps in sensor capabilities, what the development happened from 2001 to 2024, the key differences between the new Tejas Mark-1A and Tejas Mark-1, and the estimated timeframe for delivering all 220 Tejas aircraft. Tejas made its first flight in 2001, and due to some reason after 14 years of its first flight in 2015, it entered into active service with the Indian Air Force. Initially, Tejas had some shortcomings and didn't meet all the requirements set by the Air Force. To address these issues, and to meet the original requirements set for the LCA program, the development of Tejas Mark-2 was approved in November 2009 as a continuation of the LCA program. During this period, the IAF was also involved in other aircraft acquisitions and development projects. For instance, they were in the process of inducting a significant number of Su-30 Mki aircraft, while also invested in the fifth-generation fighter aircraft, FGFA program with Russia. The FGFA was supposed to involve technology transfer and produce around 150 to 200 aircraft locally. Additionally, plans were underway for the development of the medium combat aircraft, now known as the Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft. Furthermore, the IAF released a request for information to procure 126 medium multi-role combat aircraft. However, progress on Tejas Mark-2 was delayed due to limited enthusiasm from both the Indian government and the IAF. This was partly because resources and attention were diverted to other ongoing projects. Consequently, neither the Tejas Mark-2 development nor the induction of Tejas into the Air Force fleet occurred at the desired pace. Moreover, challenges were encountered in the execution of other projects as well. The FGFA program faced setbacks, and AMCA is scheduled for its maiden flight in 2027. Similarly, the MMRCA acquisition process is still ongoing, indicating delays in its completion. In March 2006, the Indian government placed an order with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited for 20 initial operational clearance, IOC standard LCA Tejas, to acquire 16 fighters and 4 trainers by December 2011. In December 2010, the Indian government ordered 20 additional LCA Tejas, 16 FOC fighters, and 4 FOC trainers from HAL. The plan was to deliver all the aircraft by December 2016. At the time of the placement of the IOC order in 2006, it was expected that the Aeronautical Development Agency, ADA, would obtain IOC in 2008, after which delivery was planned till December 2011. However, IOC has been achieved by ADA in December 2013, followed by FOC clearance in 2018. After the 2014 election when the NDA government came to power, under the guidance of Manohar Parrikar, former Defense Minister of India, IAF inducted its first IOC standard LCA Tejas in 2015. In January 2021, Indian government signed an order for 83 HAL Tejas, worth 47,000 crore rupees, roughly $5.6 billion, comprising 10 additional twin-seat trainers and 73 single-seat Tejas Mark-1A. In 2021, it was unexpected that the IAF would order another 100 Tejas aircraft. If someone had suggested that the IAF might order one or two additional squadrons of Tejas, it might have seemed believable, but the idea of 5 squadrons was out of the box. However, due to a delay of 3 to 4 years in the development of Tejas Mark-2, and considering the decreasing number of aircraft in the IAF fleet, it became a clear decision to bring in more Tejas aircraft. In March 2024, the Tejas Mark-1A completed its first flight. Now, in April 2024, the Ministry of Defense has issued a tender worth 65,000 crore rupees, roughly $8.1 billion, to HAL for an additional 97 Tejas Mark-1A fighter jets. This would bring the total number of Tejas in the IAF fleet to 220. So far, we don't have specific information. We're waiting to see if all 97 aircraft will be Mark-1A standard, or upgraded Tejas will be ordered along with trainer aircraft. We expect the deal to probably be finalized within the next 2 to 3 years, and at that point, we'll have more specifics. Currently, HAL can make 24 planes every year, and they could boost it to 36. However, they can't do this unless General Electric ramps up their production of GE-404 engines, which is currently at 20 engines per year. Without more engines, HAL can't make more planes, even if they want to. At the current rate, by 2033, all Tejas planes will be given to the Indian Air Force. Let's discuss the enhancements in the Mk-1A compared to the Mk-1 and what sensors are included. The upgraded Mk-1A Tejas aircraft brings several improvements, particularly in its avionics systems. One key upgrade is the introduction of AESA radar. Initially, the first 40 aircraft will have ELM-2052 AESA radar, while the rest will feature UTAM AESA radar. In addition to the AESA radar, the Tejas are equipped with an UNGAD Unified Electronic Warfare Suite. This suite includes sensors like a digital radar warning receiver, which alerts the pilot when they're being targeted by enemy radars, and a digital radio frequency memory-based jammer, which disrupts enemy communication and radar systems. To enhance survivability, it carries an externally mounted DRDO Advanced Self-Protection Jammer Pod. This is like having an extra layer of protection that can actively disrupt incoming threats. One thing missing from the defensive suit is the missile approach warning system. Additionally, it doesn't have an infrared search and track, IRST sensor. To address this, the Tejas can carry pod-based sensors similar to the Rafael Lightning III targeting and reconnaissance pod. Apart from these sensor upgrades, the Mk-1A also brings enhancements to its overall functionality. It will have a reduced turnaround time, meaning it can get back into action more quickly after missions. Other upgrades include a new mission computer, a digital map generator for better navigation, and dual-rack pylons to carry more air-to-air missiles. To improve pilot comfort and effectiveness, the cockpit has been reshaped. Additionally, the Mk-1A features software-defined radio-based secure communications for network-centric warfare. The question is, will there be any changes in the new order for Tejas Mk-1A? The changes might include small enhancements, like improved software or minor adjustments, but the overall aircraft design and performance are likely to remain unchanged. After the induction of all the aircraft by 2035, IAF will have 11 squadrons of Tejas Mk-1 and Mk-1A, 15 squadrons of Su-30 Mki, 2 squadrons of Rafael, 4 to 6 squadrons of Tejas Mk-2, and 2 squadrons of AMCA. Along with that, if MRFA is executed, IAF will have an additional 6 squadrons of aircraft. That's it for today. See you in the next video.